Hi, my name is Roger. In this video, I'm going to show you something that is very useful for the subtitle editor. So I'm going to do this one as well. It is called a CSV file, and that is a comma separated file. Now, what can you do with it? Well, let me just show you how it works. This here is a file I've created, and this is what's in that file. So you have fish, comma, likes, comma, to, comma, give, comma, and hope. When I press this button, it is separated at the comma. So you get, this here is a list box. This is what you get in a list box when you do each word into a column. And this here is a second text area, and you get this. So how can you do that? It's very easy. This is the same interface. This is a text area 1, text area 2, and a list box. It's very easy. We have file types, simple text, so you don't have to explain that one anymore. Then we go to the open button. All you have to do is write yourself this. It's a simple open dialog, of course, and you use a text input string. That is, if you want to have it like this here, with the comma. But that's most of the time not what you want when you have a CSV file. You want something like this, or you want something like this, or something else if you want to. This is just an example. So the open event of my list box, me.colonCount is 5. That's needed because I need colons and not rows in this particular case. So here we have, this is the code behind this push button. So when you push this button, you get this here and this here. That's what you can do when you separate something at, for example, a comma. So we're gonna need an array. Otherwise you can't use the split function. So dim words as an array, and we're gonna use strings. So it's a string array. Then we're going to say is text area dot text dot split at the comma. In this example, with the CSV file, you split at the comma. And every time it sees a comma, it splits it. So the array words looks like this one. That's basically how it looks like after the split. In the subtitle editor, I use this quite a bit, but then like this, with a pound sign, like this. Pound sign are not in subtitle files 9 out of 10 times, unless it's very badly written. But this is just to show you how you can do that. So we split it at the comma. Dim I is an integer, and C is also an integer, so you can write it like this because it's only available behind this push button. So we have again a for loop. For I is nil to words, that's our array, uBound last index. Then we're going to do text area to append text words. I is elements plus an end of line. That one line produces this here. Then our listbox1.cell, listbox1.lastindex, we have only one row. This here is your row. This here, after the comma, is in this particular case a column. And that's the one where I need C as a variable. So that's why you see C over there. Is words and then I. You don't have to do an end of line. Then we're going to say C is C plus 1. So we want to move one column ahead. And that results in this. This is the first one, second, third, and so on. Of course, it starts with nil. But this is what it looks like when you're done with your code. So that's basically it for this video. It's a very small one, very easy one, but you need to know how that works. So play a little bit around with it and see what you can come up with.